How often should I wipe hard drive free space? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here. Here's the question. I read your article about CCleaner's file deletion overwrite, which I tried. Mine took about 3 hours to do. My question is, how often should I use this file deletion in general? Once per month? I'm really clueless about this. I'm referring to CCleaner's wipe section. Well, very bluntly, I never do it. I never actually run any kind of free space wiping tool. Now, there are some reasons why you might want to, but I suspect that doing it periodically is not necessarily something you actually need to do. Of course, all of this is because when you delete a file in Windows, the data for that file is not actually removed from the hard disk. The space that it took is simply marked as available. And then later, at some random time, when another file is written to the disk, it may overwrite parts or all of that data. If that never happens, which is possible, then that data remains there and is potentially recovered by advanced tools like, say, Recova or others. Now, sometimes you may have files that you delete that you want to make absolutely certain would never be recoverable. That's when a free space wipe comes into play. Now, we have to be very careful here because most of us are never in a situation where this is truly a risk. Even with all of the personal files and things that I use on my machine every day, I simply don't feel that undeleting a file is what's going to get me in the end, right? Most people that even steal computers and hard disks and whatnot, they rarely even look at the data that's on the machine. They're interested in selling the hardware quickly. Yes, your data is still out there, but the chances of somebody actually stumbling on it and the chances of somebody going through the additional steps of using some kind of an undelete utility are actually pretty slim. Now, to be fair, there are individuals who I would call targets, high value targets. If you're in the government, if you're in politics, if you're in healthcare, if you're in any kind of business or occupation that regularly handles information that would be highly sensitive in nature and potentially valuable to a thief, then you may want to consider this. You might be a target, and therefore a theft might be something other than just trying to sell your hardware. They might literally be after your data. In a case like that, yeah, CCleaner Free has an example of a drive wiper built in. It will simply overwrite the free space on your hard disk, the free space being the space that is not currently being used by any of your files. That way, there's nothing to undelete, there's nothing to recover. And it also includes the ability to overwrite multiple times, which can be important in extreme cases of security and if you are using a magnetic style hard disk. But ultimately, a single pass for overwriting your data is really all you need. How often? Well, honestly, it depends. It depends on how important, how sensitive that recovered data is, how likely it is that your machine will fall into the hands of somebody who would be motivated to do this, and how likely it is someone would be motivated. So generally, it's not something that necessarily needs to happen on a regular schedule unless you are really a high-value target, in which case, daily, weekly, monthly, honestly, it doesn't really matter. It's probably something that you would need to coordinate with the IT team that is responsible for your overall organization to understand what their recommendations are going to be. So, bottom line, for most people, you don't need to do any of this. Honestly, it's just not that huge a risk. I don't. If you do, then a single pass overwrite of free space with a free space wiping tool like the one included in CCleaner is plenty. Do it however often you feel comfortable. Other than that, that's really all you need. Unless you're a high-value target, In which case, yes, you need to do some more investigation and understand exactly how high value you may or may not be. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5106. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.